Hey, how's it going? So, this is a lady that I hope you don't harvest. And if you do, I hope you don't harvest much of. And she is known as the Pacific Yew. Now, a lot of people get that name confused with a yew tree that grows over in the UK area. This is not that. This is a conifer lady. She is not related to that particular yew tree. But she is the Pacific Yew, and she is endangered for two reasons. She is endangered because logging, and we're on a bunch of logging land right now in the Blue Mountain Range, logging companies hate her because her wood is so strong that it snaps their drag lines. And drag lines are what they put around all the trees they've cut down to rip out the cut down trees through the woods, and she can break those real thick steel cables. I think they're made out of steel. Whatever they're made out of, she can snap them because her wood is so dense. And the second reason she's so popular is because lots of, that bug tried to get me in the eye, lots of studies are confirming that she has the amazing ability to combat breast cancer. And so unfortunately, a lot of black market harvesting is going on where people are coming out here and they are just stripping her bark completely, and unfortunately that's primarily done for the TCM, which is traditional Chinese medicine, black market. You know, the same kind of market where they're selling like powdered rhino horn and things like that. So even here in Northeast Oregon, we have a real issue with people coming in and finding these yew trees and just decimating them. And you're thinking, no big deal, I'll just go out and plant a bunch and I'll do my share to help these plants continue living. And yes, that is awesome, and we do come out and plant her berries. If you like berries, she doesn't actually create a cone. She creates, and she doesn't have any on her at the moment, she creates these tiny little red berries with a singular seed inside. But the issue with planting back is she takes an exceptionally long time to grow. I'm talking this little tree right here is my elder. She's easily a couple hundred years old, and I'm guessing she's been cut back at some point in time, but even the growth you're seeing here now is a couple hundred years old. And you're like, no way, but yes way. Totally yes way. Because if he gets close here, I can show you what she grows in a year's time frame. Okay, you see how this bit is green, like the bark is green? From here to here is all that she grew in an entire year's growing season. And so, and that's a pretty good amount. Usually, like, look, her side branches, that's all she grew in an entire year. And now we do harvest from her very sparingly, because I do believe that one way to encourage these plants to keep thriving and living is that if you're using them and you're showing them respect. However, we have a once every 2 to 3 year rule, meaning if I were to harvest from this lady, I would not come back to her for almost 3 years because I want her to grow back. And if I were to harvest from her, I would take a small amount, like I would probably not take a branch any larger than this. And then I am using all of her needles to make an amazing breast massage oil. Not only does she have cancer fighting properties, but like any other conifer tree, she can help with soreness and tenderness in your breasts, a little bit with dissolving cysts and stuff, and you is kind of like the holy grail of that. But again, if you are going to harvest this lady, if you are somebody who is battling breast cancer or is at a high risk for it, she can be your ally with that if you're respectable of her. And now I even use up the little pieces of wood here. Now, she's traditionally by a lot of First Nations, they were using her for to make their bows. And that's because she is very bendy and she is so strong. You are hard pressed to break this lady when she's green. And even when she's been cured out to make a bow, she can handle that bending without breaking. So often I will make sure that I am utilizing the little bit of wood that I'm getting here. I'm usually making crochet hooks and things like that for myself. But anyhow, so I just thought although I talked about harvesting and I talked about not harvesting, getting this information out there is vital, because you might just read, oh, Pacific Yew is really good for breast cancer, cool. And then, you know, or you might want to make a bow and then you come out here and you chop this lady down. But if you've watched this, you now know how important it is to take from her sparingly. In fact, when I make a breast massage oil with her leaves, I really only offer it one time a year, and that's because we are hiking for miles to find plants that we haven't harvested off of within 2 to 3 years. And these little guys, honestly, I wouldn't touch them because they're trying so hard. There are quite a few of them popping up around here, and that tells me that these are probably regrowth from when they logged in the 20s, this area really heavily. They're still doing logging, unfortunately, but when they used to come in and just really drag rip these lands. And so they are growing back. But anyhow, that's Pacific Yew, and she is just an amazing ally. And if you find her in the wild, even if you're not harvesting from her, pay deep reverence. And if you see her berries, gather her berries, which have her seed in it, and plant them. Granted, by the time the new tree is about that big, you might pass on. But you'll know that you'll have done that for that ally. So if you like hearing me talk about these plant allies, even if there's somebody that I don't recommend you harvesting a lot of or using a lot of, make sure to subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications by clicking the little bell icon below the video. That helps you know not only when I've uploaded new videos, but like exactly when I've uploaded them. The notification things is very handy. Like and comment. Comment because it gets conversation going in the threads. It really can answer a lot of questions. If you ask a question, if you have one question and I answer you, you could answer hundreds of people that had the same question. And so that's really handy. And it helps people find me. And speaking of find me, come find me on Instagram, come find my website, come interact with me. And you can do all that by following the links here in my bio. So you are definitely smart enough to come out here and find this lady and pay respect to her and utilize her if you truly need to. And thanks for watching, and I will see you next time, okay? Bye.